Good day, ladies and gentlemen. I'm Just Plain Living, and I'm John Gray.
Good morning. I'm Peggy Burton, and I've brought with me Country Man.
It's time.
Wave
to him, Country Man. There you go.
How long has Country Man been around?
Fran Barber made Country Man. Fran Barber. She does a lot of stuff for the seniors over at the senior building, and they dance and they play and carry on. And she brought this to me one day. He used to always be on the set.
Right.
Maybe he'll go back on the set this
year. He needs
to
go back on the set.
I was thinking that Country Man was with us. We'd have him on TV about this time of the year.
Yeah.
We were at the Legion.
Yeah.
It's been that long.
Yeah. Country Man needs a cowboy hat.
Well, Country Man, I did get a bandana on him today, yeah. But it was so hot he didn't want to wear his hat.
He didn't want to wear his hat.
So I'm not wearing a hat today.
I don't blame him. And speaking about that, I want you folks to remember this right here. Aqua Hydrate,
and
this is some great water.
It's
hot out there, folks. Make sure you stay hydrated. Don't go out and not be hydrated and fall over and have to call Chief Black.
See what people forget? They forget that plain water does not have the electrolyte stuff in it.
This is good stuff, and this is brought to you by our water sponsor. That's Mid-South Distributing right here, Rick Gerwe and his family, and they do a lot of great things for the community and for us.
And
it's football season. It's about ready to kick off, and they're our water sponsor for the football show.
And it's time.
It's time. It's time to drink plenty of water because it is hot out there, folks.
Are any players just dropping in the heat? That worries me.
Well, Coach Olive's going to be on a little bit later today on the show, and we'll talk about some of those things. And we'll tell the old story, Fuller and I will, about when we walked 5 miles uphill in the snow both ways to school.
Yeah, right.
And practiced football. They didn't let us have water.
That's right.
We took salt pills, and it's a wonder we any of us were alive. Because now, and they've learned a whole lot about that stuff and about how you work out. They didn't want us lifting weights because they thought it'd make you muscle bound and you couldn't run. And it's all completely different.
They totally discouraged it if you were a baseball player that's not good for you.
No.
Now look at these guys.
Oh, these guys are monsters. Now.
Yeah.
They're in the weight room all the time, and the girls as well.
Yeah.
Female athletes. You look at some of these female athletes, and they are cut, ripped, and strong.
Yeah.
And you got to be to perform.
Oh, sure.
That's what it takes these days. Well, I'm just glad to see Country Man.
Countryman,
he's looking good.
He couldn't find his shoes this morning.
His boots,
but he's got his five toes in order. So
five toes are there. And,
his toes are in the sand sometimes.
There you go. Well,
so when does the South Jackson Country, when does that start?
It's the 7th of August.
7th,
8th, and 9th,
okay.
That'd be next Thursday, Election Day.
Yeah.
Starts on Election Day. No, that's practice.
Yeah.
So it's 7th, 8th, and 9th.
7th, 8th, and 9th.
7th is Election Day.
That's
Thursday.
I believe it's 6th.
So it's 8, 9, and 10.
7th?
7th is Friday.
7th is Friday. 6th is Election Day.
Yeah,
okay.
Yeah.
I'd like to give a shout out to our sponsors.
Chief knows everything, if you noticed.
I love the Chief, and I'm glad he knows everything. He keeps us safe.
That's right.
So you folks out there who may be considering committing a crime, just keep in mind.
Chief
Blackwell probably knows about it.
Yeah. Knows everything. Knows it.
Yeah,
you know,
he probably knows about it.
Robert Osteen, R.K. Osteen, was one of our coaches, and he's one of those guys that he knew you could go out on a Thursday night and do something you weren't supposed to do, and Friday morning when you got to school, he already knew it.
Yeah.
So Chief Black was sort of like that. Those guys like that got their ear to the ground, folks. You can't get away from them.
My father was like that.
Was he?
Did he know when you snuck out? He had me figured out way before I did.
He could see it in your eyes.
He could tell in my voice, yeah.
Some of these parents are a lot sharper than you give them credit for.
Hey, I got a phone call this morning from Sister Candy, and she just wanted me to know, to where you could know, that today, she heard this on the radio, today is the 115th anniversary of the hamburger.
No kidding.
Yeah, Philip, you got me one?
Oh my gosh.
Look at that right there.
Boy, that's a hamburger.
That's a hamburger. I don't know whose that is, but it's good.
Yeah.
It's looking good.
72 waistline.
Yeah. So the chief, I was talking to the chief about it, and he asked, where? And I said, well, I don't know. So he did a little research on his phone, and he said that there was some guy that did one back in the 1880s, but I don't know if he had the stamp of approval on that or whatever. So
you talking about the hamburger?
Hamburger, yeah. Right. So we'll say it's 115 years old.
It is, you know, hung in there all these years.
We used to make these hamburgers at the office, my other office, not here. And they were called, we cooked them in this Foreman, George Foreman thing, which cooked all the grease out of it.
Yeah, I have one.
Well, how could they be any good without any grease in it?
They weren't all that good, actually, in retrospect. But, however, they were huge. I mean, you know, it must have been a pound of meat on those things. And I'm thinking, how stupid was that? You know, you'd been better off eating a quarter pound of meat that had some grease in it than trying to eat that and think it was healthy, for goodness sake.
Do you remember Farmer's Pool Hall downtown in the alley?
Yes, I do remember that.
It's about where the back entrance to, well, now it was First National Bank, and now it's the Avenues downtown. But it's about where that back entrance was there. And there's a guy in there named Lard.
I remember Lard.
That ran it.
Right.
And they made a hamburger in there. Listen, well, he was bigger than me. They made a hamburger in there. It wasn't real big. It was about that big, but it was about that thick. And the only thing they put on it was mayonnaise on both sides and onion.
And that was it.
And that's it. And that
wonderful
grease just dripping, just running off of it.
And they were good.
Oh, they were good. Somebody said, does Lard ever clean his grill down there? And I said, oh, no, that'd kill all that. I mean, it's like,
taste, right?
Well, yeah, it's like an iron skillet that's been seasoned. You know, you can't do
skillet.
That.
Yeah. Iron skillet.
Yeah, you know, and folks that haven't lived in Tullahoma most of their life really missed out on a lot of great things, because that alley there was the place to be.
It was
the Duck's Pool Room and Farmers and Pete's.
And Pete's, and where
Pete's,
London's
which is now London's, you know. I mean, you know.
And back during Camp Forest days, when there was 100,000 soldiers here.
Right.
Those places stayed open almost 24 hours a day, because with 100,000 people, there's 25,000 people off work all the time.
All the time.
Yeah.
Right.
And they say that they had in Pete's in there that they would have a keg, and they'd open a keg and turn the tap on and never turn it off till it was empty.
Good grief.
Yeah.
There were that many people waiting in line to drink beer.
Unbelievable.
I mean, can you imagine, folks, this town with 100,000 people in it?
That is hard to imagine.
That's why I like living here close in, because it's a small town. Love it.
You know, but there was like Fran's grandmother's house over on Atlantic Street. You know, there were people sleeping in every room in every house, in garages.
Yeah.
Their garage out there, they put cots in the garage because there were so many people here, there was nowhere for them to go.
Yeah.
I barely remember this, but there was people that would actually ask my parents if they could throw a tent in the yard or on the property that they didn't have a house to live in.
Yeah.
I remember a mother and a son. I was very small, but their husband, I guess, was in the Army. And
the soldiers, a lot of them stayed out on the base. They had you remember those old barracks that were out there on the...
And I guess all of those are gone now. They've all been torn down.
Yes. But what it was is you had the support staff.
Yeah.
You know, everybody that worked out there feeding those soldiers and doing what they had to do,
plus
everything that had to happen in town to support, you know, their needs, shopping and all that stuff, those people. And a lot of them had family members that would come here, and there was nowhere for them to stay.
Yeah.
I think probably typical of any base, foreign or here, that surrounding it is usually lots of activity.
Oh, yeah.
And lots of good things going on, some bad things going on.
And there were a lot of people from out of town. You know, there were a lot of people like from New York and Chicago and different business people that follow military life like that. And they had businesses. And I would imagine that that's probably the reason that Joe Rico ever came down here and started Rico's Pizza.
Well, you know, and a lot of people got very wealthy.
Very, very wealthy.
At that period,
it was all over. They packed up and left.
Yeah.
Went back to where they came from.
Yeah.
But all those buildings downtown, like up above Couches and Daddy Billy's and up above Clayton's and all of those stores that were down there, the upstairs were all used. There were businesses in all the upstairs and offices and things like that because the town was just full.
Busy time. Miss Cersei remembers all that.
She remembers
well.
It. Bob remembered all of it very well.
He really phenomenal memory he had, and his involvement through photography kept a lot of that alive. Have you all ever been through all of his photography?
I mean, it's impossible.
It's
massive.
It needs to be.
Oh yeah,
it's massive.
And he knew where every piece of it was. Bob's one of those guys. His desk would be stacked up with papers like that high. But if you move something,
he wouldn't know where it was.
He wouldn't know where it was. You ask him for something, and he could reach you.
And finally,
he knew where everything was. So it's just. But it was great times for this town. And if you see some of the old pictures, across from Couches down there, that what is a parking lot now, and where the caboose is on the other side. But that was a city park right there, where that parking lot was. Mm-hmm. And there was a big bandstand there where they would have band play on the weekends and stuff.
That was nice. And are all those big homes there, were they built during that time maybe, or earlier?
They were built
before then, I think. Yeah.
Most of those homes were railroad homes.
Were they?
Yeah.
Like people that were helping on the railroad?
Well, I would say management style people.
Look at that.
If you're not going to put boots on him, you need to take him somewhere and get his nails polished.
Yeah, you need his nails.
You know, we're just having fun here, folks, and we're going to have some more. Don't you go away. We'll be back with a great show for you later on after this quick commercial break.
The Kia Summer's on Us sales event is going on right now at Russell Barnett Kia of Tullahoma. Let me tell you about this event. Purchase a new Kia Sedona, Kia Optima, Kia Forte, and receive 0% financing up to 66 months and your first three payments for free. For a limited time only, no strings attached. With America's best warranty, the 10-year, 100,000-mile powertrain warranty, Kia is the power to surprise. The Kia Summer's on Us sales event going on right now. Why buy anywhere else?
All I have to do to think about what I was physically before and what I am now, and I don't ever want to go back to that original situation.
The overall mission of the rehab team is always what is best for the patient and how we can facilitate maximum potential from every resident.
Well, the most important thing to me is that I'm allowed to do whatever I want to do, you know.
Everyday miracles at Life Care Center of Tullahoma.
Get your news first, fast, and free with your news leader on 6 every Tuesday, Thursday, and Saturday nights at 6, 8, and 10 p.m. Local weather, sports, community calendar events, and a comprehensive look at the latest news stories and newsmakers as only a video news broadcast can do. Get it first, fast, and free with News Leader on Channel 6, your local information network.
Welcome back, ladies and gentlemen. This is our segment we call Police Pointers, and here with us today is Tullahoma Police Chief Paul Blackwell. By the way, Paul, last time you were here, we talked about bail bondsmen and bounty hunters and such stuff like that, and I have had since then several people mention to me that they appreciated us doing that because they just weren't familiar with that, how that stuff works.
We're glad that people are listening and getting something out of this.
Yeah, that's right. Actually, I got something out of it too because when you get a bondsman to go on your bail, then you sign a contract which lets them come in your house, if you fail to live up to the terms.
You give up some freedoms.
Yeah, exactly. So that was some good information. But now it's time for something else.
That's right. It's that time of the year where the parents are maybe doing the happy dance.
Yeah.
And the kids are doing the I don't want to do it. And that's,
right.
That's go back to school.
Mm-hmm.
School does start in Tullahoma officially tomorrow, Wednesday. And, you know, a lot of things will change, not just the kids going to school but our traffic flow will increase greatly.
Yes.
Because parents are going to have to take the kids to school. The traffic lights, the school zone lights will start flashing. So a lot is going to occur tomorrow. We know people are going to be frustrated stressed out, you know, anxious, yes. You know, all of those terms that go with everything happening tomorrow. What we do want to remind people is that the school will be back in session. That means there'll be school zones in the morning and in the afternoon. And all of our school zones are designated by the yellow flashing overhead lights.
Mm-hmm.
And when those are on, the speed limit's 15 miles an hour. And we know that's going to be a big adjustment for people. For the last 2.5 months, they haven't had to worry with that. And now all of a sudden tomorrow, and especially if you don't have kids.
Right.
You know, you're going to find yourself going down the road and wondering, why are these cars driving so slow right. as you're passing them?
I hadn't thought about that, but
it happens right out on Jackson
yeah,
a lot.
Yeah, if you don't have children, you don't know about
that. You're not as conscious that school's back in session. And it's not uncommon to be on Jackson Street and be going the 15 miles an hour, and a car passes you a little bit faster, and we stop them, or I stop them because I'm in an unmarked car. And they, you know, and they'll tell you, well, I was wondering why everybody was driving so slow. There's an adjustment, and we understand that, and we're not looking to slam somebody the first or second day.
Yeah.
But, you know, people have to be aware speed limits will change during those times. And with that, of course, a lot of our students, it's still nice weather. They're going to be walking to school, riding their bikes. Parents will be walking with them. So around our schools, pedestrian traffic will increase as well.
Yeah, and that's pretty important, because I guess in these school zones, 15 miles an hour is quite appropriate, because you, especially with smaller children, you have no idea what they might do if they're walking or on a bicycle or something.
And the school
like
zones
that.
Are really a short distance, so it's not like you're traveling a mile or 2 miles at 15, like you're on the interstate and you're going 15, you think, this is taking forever. You know, our school zones are relatively short, so it's not that big of a distraction or disruption to slow down and to watch the kids. Because you're right, a lot of our children, maybe elementary age, you know, they're excited. They're excited to be going to school, excited to see their friends, and you never know when one might dart out in the street or, you know, try to cross at somewhere they shouldn't be crossing at.
Right.
So, yes, it's definitely important that drivers be attentive and follow the 15-mile-an-hour speed zone.
Who sets the speed zones? Does the city do that? Or?
There's a state law that sets a speed zone, but then it gives latitude to the city to where they can adjust their speed limits. If you're in some locations where maybe the school is out on a four-lane road or something, your school zone may be a little bit higher. But because all of ours are located within the city and congested, that all of ours are posted at 15 miles an hour.
Yeah, okay. So do you, and I'm sure that your officers will routinely patrol these school zones to make sure people are complying with the
and they will. It's kind of a an instruction to them is that, you know, each officer works a particular zone. And whatever school is in your zone, you're responsible for patrolling that school zone in the morning and the afternoon to ensure that people are following the traffic regulations. Now, of course, if they're busy on another call and they can't do it, we'll try to get another officer over there. But, you know, the public should see a police officer in those school zones fairly frequently.
And I think also you have crossing guards in most, if not all, the schools.
We do. We have a crossing guard at each school. We have a total of 8 crossing guards. We only have 7 schools. There's one school out at East Lincoln where we have 2 crossing guards. And they're kind of our eyes and ears as well. If there is a traffic problem, if someone is repeatedly speeding through the school zone, they see them. And they will let us know that, hey, we've got this little red Toyota that comes in every morning and, you know, lickety-split.
Yeah.
So we'll get out there and we'll start looking for them. So our crossing guards are very important to us. Their job is to get the students across the street.
Mm-hmm.
They're not really traffic control directors. But a lot of times they do get involved in stopping vehicles and helping the flow of traffic. But but people should not expect that of them. It's not really what their duty is. But we appreciate they take the initiative to help get the traffic flowing.
But of course, in the event of an emergency or some sort where the officers are tied up, that's all you got there, right?
The crossing guard.
Yeah, mm-hmm. So that's got to be really important to
us. It is important to us, and it's important that the public understand that you know, these folks are standing out in the middle of the road. So, you know, cars going down both sides of them. Mm-hmm. And it's important that people drive the speed limit 15 miles an hour when you go through there. Now, the downside, if you get a ticket, it's $165. And, yeah. You know, there's not many of us that just have $165 sitting in your pocket to give up for speeding.
Yeah.
So it's everybody's benefit to slow down. You really don't increase your arrival time
right.
by going a little bit faster.
Right.
If you get stopped by an officer, you're definitely not getting to where you thought you were going to get when you thought you were going to get there. Follow that?
Yeah, exactly.
I said to myself, said I to me,
yeah, right.
I did not get there any faster than I thought I was going
exactly.
to. So it doesn't pay off to speed.
Yeah.
And again, if you do get caught speeding, ask yourself the question, is it just the first time I've ever done it? Or how I just finally got caught.
It's the first time I got caught.
You know, because everybody wants to look at the police officer as the mean old policeman writing a ticket.
Yeah.
But if we're honest with ourselves, how many of us have not been caught doing that?
Yeah.
So when you do get caught, it was just Murphy's Law, or it's your turn, take it. And you know, deal with it in the proper way.
And you know, I'll tell this quick story, and I told it last year, but I was driving through this school zone at the high school last year on Jackson Street, and the crossing guard said, slow down, slow down, slow down, and he was a little bit, you know, angry about it at the time. And I had someone with me, and I said, what is the matter with him? I'm not speeding. And my passenger said, yeah, you were.
You were.
You were doing 30 miles an hour when you came through there.
So, you know, so the next time you come through, you kind of,
yeah,
you know,
exactly.
Don't look at me.
Absolutely.
But, you know,
absolutely.
We need the cooperation of the public, of the community, because these are our children going to school. You know, the traffic regulations are put in place to ensure the safe and orderly movement of vehicles on the road.
Right.
And we've said before, if we didn't have the rules and regulations, it would be total chaos. So understand that the officers are out there just trying to make sure our roads are safe, our children are safe, and that everybody has to abide by the same rules and regulations.
But you know, you touched on this earlier, though, it probably takes people a few days to get used to that because they're not used to that speed zone thing happening there. So.
And it does. And what a lot of officers will tell you, because they run radar in their car, you can, what I call the nosedive. You can see a car coming and all of a sudden they may be going 45 miles an hour.
Yeah.
And you see that radar, the target readout go 45, 40, 35, 33, you know, down to 15.
Right.
It's like either they all of a sudden noticed it or they saw the police car or something triggered them. But, you know, it's fun when you sit in a car with your radar and you can see, you know, those that are
I'm sure. And probably those cars and the crossing guards and the lights, and it takes all that to make that happen where people obey the laws, because I've done it too. You get up on there and you're thinking of something else, and all of a sudden you think, oh man, I'm in a
school zone.
So, you know.
So be cognizant of it. We know tomorrow and probably the rest of this week is going to be a transition period. You know, and I hope we continue to do what we normally do, and that's try to educate people.
Yeah.
But, you know, say next week, the education part may be over, and, you know, now it's time to start being a little more enforcement.
Yeah, because the worst thing, of course, you don't want it to happen to you. You don't want to be the person that hits a child or something
right.
like that.
Right, and especially if you're taking a child somewhere, you need to be very conscious of your own speed, because it could be your child that we're trying to protect.
Yeah. All right. Folks, wake up, be awake, be safe. Paul, thank you so much.
Alrighty.
Always a pleasure to have
thank
you here. We'll be right back in a moment, folks, right after this.
We get closer to a world with more birthdays when we take cancer patients by the hand. we help them find answers and guidance and hope, and give them more candles to light. We're the American Cancer Society. Help create a world with more birthdays at morebirthdays.com.
Serving you as a local firefighter.
Proudly served our country and the United States Air Force.
Serving Tullahoma.
Helping our kids.
Hi, I'm Terry Stroop. Your comfort is our service. We'd like to thank Tullahoma for the privilege of serving your heating and cooling needs.
When your family suffers the loss of a loved one, the caring and compassionate staff at Tullahoma Funeral Home and Coffee County Funeral Chapel are standing by to assist you in every way possible. We are proud to support local industry and offer only Batesville caskets. Many funeral homes don't own or operate a crematory. We utilize the only crematory in Coffee County. Your loved one never leaves Coffee County. We can accommodate any need and any budget. Consider our complete pre-need service to remove this burden from your family during their time of grief. Lock in today's low costs and protect from inflation. Tullahoma Funeral Home and Coffee County Funeral Chapel. Our family caring for your family.
All right, folks, yesterday there was a ribbon cutting at our splash park and indoor pool at Tullahoma, and we were down there. And, of course, the indoor pool opened about a month and a half ago, and they're averaging about over 500 people a day, and that's even including the days when we had rain and thunderstorms. And I think their biggest day was 906 people, which is absolutely amazing. But yesterday, the indoor pool is also finished now, and so we were down there for the ribbon cutting, and we brought a little video.
All right, ladies and gentlemen, this is the ribbon cutting for the indoor and outdoor swimming facilities in Tullahoma, and it's a good day. Both facilities are open and ready to go now, and we're in the snack bar right now. And the place is filling up, and this is going to be a good, good day for Tullahoma. And the mayor's arrived, and there's Mike North, president of the Chamber of Commerce, and our aldermen are here. There's Mr. Stanton, and Mr. Mathis, Mr. Duncan, and Mr. Lindemann over there, and Mr. Bay Keene. So the city is well represented. There's Chief there. So it's a good day. Hi, folks. I'm with Kirk Glick, now the director of Parks and Rec, and this is a great day for him. Kirk, you've got both of your facilities going to open up and get a ribbon cutting today.
That's right. It's been a long time coming, but we're open at both facilities now. The outdoor pool's been open a while, about a month or so now, but the indoor pool, it's just recently opened, so we're happy to have both things up and running now.
And the outdoor pool is found great success over the last month and a half.
That's right. It's been very popular. We've been averaging a little over 500 people a day at the pool, and that's even taken into account some real slow days because of rain and thunderstorms. Our high is 906 people for a day.
Wow.
And we've had several people over the 800 mark, but we did. We scared the 900 mark for several days and then finally broke it at 906.
Well, that's great. Congratulations, and we're mighty proud of you and all the hard work that's gone into getting these facilities operational for the citizens of Tullahoma. As Lane Curley would say, it's a great day to be in Tullahoma.
Yes, it is.
All right, buddy. Thank you.
Thank you.
All right, this is the ribbon cutting for the indoor pool here in Tullahoma, opening up today and after the remodel. And everybody's proud and everybody's excited.
The Tullahoma Area Chamber of Commerce and the city of Tullahoma and all of those people that love to stay wet, especially during weather like this, let's cut the ribbon of this indoor swimming pool and let's officially kick it off as the new pool. Yay!
All right, ladies and gentlemen, this is the ribbon cutting for the outdoor pool.
On behalf of the Tullahoma Area Chamber of Commerce and the City of Tullahoma,
the ribbon cutting for the outdoor pool.
It's time for every family and business in Tullahoma to go green and recycle. Tullahoma Public Works makes it simple and easy to recycle. Just place your recyclable materials, paper, plastic, aluminum, and cardboard, beside your garbage container on the same day your garbage is picked up. Your recycled materials don't have to be in a fancy container. Recycling is not only the right thing to do, it makes sense. Recycling pays. Paying to bury our garbage costs each of us. Please do your part. Let's go green, Tullahoma, and recycle.
Hello, my name is Ray Norris. I'm a candidate for Alderman in the August 6th election. I'm a 49-year resident of Tullahoma and understand the needs of our city. I have an aerospace business background and worked for Microcraft for 31 years, helping grow that company from a 25-man regional machine shop to a nationally recognized company with over 700 employees. After retiring from Microcraft, I started my own consulting business and have been very active in civic and service organizations, including Rotary, in which I served as district governor for the eastern half of the state. As your alderman, I'll strive to bring new industry and retail business to our city. I'll be accessible and responsive. I'll listen to your concerns and I'll help you find solutions to your problems. I'd be honored to have your vote and serve as your alderman. Thank you.
Hi, I'm Cindy.
And I'm Jacob. I'm the rooster.
And I'm the red mate. And we would like to welcome you to
Roosterwear.
Yes, Roosterwear is a cottage industry producing accessories for men, women, children, babies, and pets. All items are hand-cut and sewn locally. Roosterwear specializes in bow ties, pocket squares, scarves, cufflinks, neckties, and aprons of all sizes for all ages. Baby products include onesies, diaper covers, bibs, and burp pads. All bow ties, tie-it-yourself, or pre-tied come with an adjustable neckband. All products can be made with a material of your choice, as special orders are available upon request. Don't be standing back looking at fashion. Create your own with Roosterwear.
Come visit us at
roosterandredmaiden.com
to find our handcrafted designs for
the cock of the walk.
Everybody has a dream. Mine was to see the ocean. And with a little help, I made it.
Get your news first, fast, and free with your news leader on 6 every Tuesday, Thursday, and Saturday nights at 6, 8, and 10 p.m. Local weather, sports, community calendar events, and a comprehensive look at the latest news stories and newsmakers as only a video news broadcast can do. Get it first, fast, and free with News Leader on Channel 6, your local information network.
Back. You're going to be so glad you hung around today because I've brought some people from South Jackson Goes Country, and I'm delighted to introduce Martha Brooke Powers, which some of you may know. Martha Brooke is directing the warm-up, all three warm-up shows, and we have brought three wonderful individuals that are the Freeze family that will be singing on the show, and I'm going to let you guys introduce yourself. Starting with you.
I'm Alyssa Freeze. I am 9 years old.
And you have a brother and a sister and another one at home, right? Okay, what's your name?
Branham.
Put it right over his face. You are who?
Branham.
Branham, right? Well, we're so glad. I love that hat. You're looking so fine. And your sister?
Eliza.
And Eliza, how old are you?
8.
8 years old. So we have 8, 9, and 3. Branham, did you tell me you were 3 years old? Okay. And Martha Brooke, What made you decide you could direct the warm-up show?
Well, I've been in South Jackson Ghost Country since I was probably in, I think, second grade was my first year.
About this age.
About their age, yes. And so I just love it. It's one of my favorite things to do every single year. And I think this is my third year directing it.
I know, and you're doing a great job.
And I love kids, and I love working with little ones like these three.
They're easy to work with, aren't they?
Oh, yes. They're so talented.
Each country show, which comes off the 7th, 8th, 9th, has a warm-up show prior to the main show. And we are growing young talent by doing this show, and we have asked them if they would sing a song today. Are you guys ready?
Yes.
And what's the name of this song?
As I Went Down to the River to Pray.
As I Went Down to the River to Pray. So if you're ready to roll that in the back, we'll sing that song.
You want to stand up or do you want to stay seated?
You can stand up.
What about that good old way to shout with the starry crown? Good Lord, show me the way. Oh, sisters, let's go down, come on down. Oh, sisters, let's go down, down to the river to pray. As I went down to the river to pray, studying about that good old way, and you shall wear a robe and crown, good Lord, show me the way. Oh, brothers, let's go down, let's go down, come on down. Oh, brothers, let's go down, down to the river to pray. As I went down to the river to pray, studying about that good old way, and you shall wear a starry crown, good Lord, show me the way. Oh, sinners, let's go down, come on down. Oh, sinners, let's go down, down to the river to pray. As I went down to the river to pray, studying about that good old way, and you shall wear a robe and crown, good Lord, show me.
Cool. Tell me, when do you like doing this, performing?
I like to have the people watch me do it, and I love to sing and dance.
And you've done a lot of it.
Yes.
You've done several shows at South Jackson with the Playhouse and with PACT and different things. And Martha Brooke, tell us when the show comes off for the warm-up shows.
What time it starts.
Yeah, what time it starts each night.
It starts at... Well, the main show starts at 7:30, right?
Correct.
So our warm-up shows on Friday and Saturday starts at 6:30. Or no, 7 o'clock. And so then also we have, if you want to mention, we have a little outdoor show that
starts
on Friday and Saturday night at, is it 6 o'clock?
It starts around 6 or 6:15, and we have barbecue for sale, so you can eat and watch the Rhythm Express Cloggers out in front of the Civic mm-hmm. Center. And I believe Gracie Lewis and Macy Tabor will
yes.
be doing...
Branson Wells.
And Branson, along with the Cloggers, will do yes. a little free show outside while you eat. And you can come mm-hmm. inside to eat if you like, or you can go outside.
And then on Sunday, our warm-up show starts at 1:30.
Correct.
So.
And each show is 30 minutes, and they're all ages, actually.
All ages.
The oldest one is probably 16,
yes.
or something like that. And they're doing songs of all types. And honestly, I think the warm-up show sometimes is the
most... Oh, and I love it. It's so much fun because it's almost like a group effort because everybody joins in on the choruses, and it's just, I mean, they get to stay on stage the whole time. So even when you're not singing, you're performing.
Exactly. So. And if you want to buy tickets, it's 455-5321 or southjackson.org and go to events, tickets, and you get tickets online now, which is really nice. And Fran is so busy at the Civic Center, it's nice when you go ahead and get your tickets ahead of time.
And tickets ahead of time are $16, and then at the door they're $18.
Yeah, I think that's correct.
Yeah.
So get your tickets early. And I know that Martha Brooke is already a college girl. And she started out just like you all. In the old days, we used to do a Grand Ole Opry show. Who was it you did at first, do you remember?
Who sang Harper Valley PTA. That's who I did my very first year.
And I thought that was really cute. So we might think about doing that again.
That would be so much
fun. There's so much talent in this town. We have a huge amount of people involved, but to me, it's the family the idea of family where young people, old people get together and do stuff. Branham, tell me something. Do you like to sing? You do, and you have the best smile. I'm loving those teeth. And how about you? Do you love to sing too? When did you all start singing together?
I don't know.
You just started singing one day and kept it up? Well, we're going to encourage you to buy tickets for South Jackson Goes Country. It's for a wonderful organization that's struggling to stay alive so we can keep the performing arts alive in our community. It's August 7, 8, 9. Remember, there's an outdoor show. There's barbecue for sale, so you can come there and stay and eat. The outdoor show starts about 6:15. And inside 7 o'clock, the warm-up show with the likes of these. I think you guys are on all the shows, aren't you?
Yes.
You are, and that's a really wonderful thing. So all I can say is thank you for coming. And Martha Brooke, I couldn't be doing this if I didn't have you.
Oh.
I mean, she has taken such a load off of me. Mm-hmm. We'll be back with more. Thank you.
Let the Smokehouse be your mountain getaway destination in beautiful Monteagle, Tennessee. Enjoy our cabins, restaurant, and old general store. Shop thesmokehouse.com featuring homemade barbecue sauces, jellies, and many other fine Tennessee products. Our live Music on the Mountain series features some of the best local and Nashville talent every Friday and Saturday night, 6:30 p.m. No cover, kids welcome.
If you want to be a parent, it doesn't matter how you play, what you wear, how you dance, or even what direction life takes you. You just need to be there. You don't have to be perfect to be a perfect parent. Thousands of teens in foster care don't need perfection. They just need you.
How long has it been since you raced a cheetah? Are your tornado creating skills getting rusty? Tired of being the only one in your neighborhood who hasn't built a dinosaur? Sounds like it's time to visit the Hands-On Science Center. The Hands-On Science Center is an indoor science playground. In this museum, please touch is the rule. Join us for weekly science demonstrations on space, lasers, lizards, rocks, and a whole lot more. No two visits are ever the same, so visit often to see our ever-changing exhibits and demonstrations. The Hands-On Science Center, 101 Mitchell Boulevard in Tullahoma.
All right, ladies and gentlemen, this past weekend, Wild Sage Entertainment Group held the first annual independent country music festival on the grounds of South Jackson. And there were vendors and about 26 bands from all over the Southeast came in there to entertain and had a lot of fun, a lot of good food, a lot of people, a lot of great music. And here's a little bit of video on that.
All right, ladies and gentlemen, we're on the grounds of South Jackson Civic Center, and this is the Independent Music Tullahoma Country Music Festival. And this place is packed with vendors and folks. There's everything from ice cream to you name it. And there's up to 26 bands playing here over the next 3 days. And there's everything from ice cream in a fire truck to glow sticks and bubble machines. Look there. Wild Bill, there's Wild Bill's old-fashioned soda pop company. And I think Curly Curtis is on the stage right now. And that's one of the featured bands. Thank you. listen to this music. And again, there's all kinds of vendors, everything from balloons to jewelry to clothing, you name it. They've got food. They've got it all right here on the property of South Jackson Civic Center. It is the Independent Tullahoma Country Music Festival. I'm here with Josh and Justin right now, the promoters of the Tullahoma Country Music Festival that's taking place over the last 3 days. And these guys are both either brown or burned. It's been hot out here. How have things gone, man?
I think it went well. We had a great time here in Tullahoma with this. We've had some great bands come in from all across the East Coast. It's been hot, very hot. And we're thankful for everybody that came out and supported us.
Well, you had a lot of vendors here, and Justin, I noticed you're a little bit tanner than Josh is. You must have used sunscreen.
Yes, we got a little bit on there, and everybody's just had a great time today. It's been fun, and we'd hope to look forward to next year.
All right, so you think we'll try this again?
Oh, yeah, definitely.
That's great. I tell you what, these are two entrepreneurs right here in Tullahoma involved in the independent music business, and we're mighty proud that they've chosen here to have this event. And guys, just good luck and thank you. And we hope to see you next time.
I wanna see the world, I want you by my side, forever and always, until the day I die, laughing and enjoying. I was like, can't think who that is you. And often can't dream who that is you. And often wanna be that is you. You're so deep, Dave. Often can't think who that is you. And often can't dream who that is you. And often wanna be that is you. You're so deep, Dave.
Time, maybe you were just building a bridge, a business, or a community. Maybe you were simply working for a home or a better tomorrow. At the time, you served out of duty and love of country. But in that time, we see a legacy created, an American dream lived. The rehab team at Life Care Center of Tullahoma is ready to help you live well.
Safely is just a click away, and choosing the right seat for your little one's age and size will take you down the road to safer travels.
How can I ever thank you enough?
Visit safercar.gov/the right seat.
I'm meteorologist Leland Statham from the News Channel 5 Weather Center. Look to Jim Fuller and crew for local news night here on Channel 6.
Welcome back. We are going to talk about the nursing home here in Tullahoma, and I have Lois Tormalin with me today. Hi, Lois.
Hello.
I'm so glad I got your name right.
Thank you.
I'm never really
nice
sure.
To meet you.
And
baby.
You're a nurse.
No, ma'am. I'm a registered dietitian.
Oh, a registered dietitian.
Yes,
and
ma'am.
And we're going to talk about the diet of some of the patients.
Sure.
At the nursing home here in Tullahoma. Are you doing for both?
I also go to Lynchburg Nursing
okay.
Center, which is a life care
and
facility.
I hear good things about them.
Well, thank you.
I really do. I've known somebody that went there.
Well, I appreciate that.
Yeah.
And we think we have two fine facilities right
so
here.
So what
in
actually,
Tennessee.
As a dietitian, but I mean, I know you don't cook the meals, but what is it you do?
As a dietitian, it's my responsibility to go in, Peggy, and assess every individual that comes in to our nursing facility.
Well, that's encouraging.
You know, we have patients that come for short-term rehab, and then we have others that come for long-term care. But we individually do a nutritional assessment on every resident.
On every resident that comes in, and you make sure that they're getting a balanced diet, if at all possible?
Absolutely.
And at the same time, try to keep them happy?
Yes. We look at their height, their weight, their skin, integrity, their lab work.
Do you find a lot of people come in dehydrated?
Yes, ma'am. Unfortunately, they do sometimes. So we want to make sure we assess for their calorie needs, their protein needs, their fluid needs. And we look at what diet that doctor's ordered. And then we work with the doctors and the nurse practitioners to make sure it is an appropriate.
And you're probably
diet
looking, if they have teeth, can they chew it?
Absolutely. That's mm-hmm. a real important thing. Many of our older adults do have chewing problems
mm-hmm.
or swallowing problems. And we have an excellent staff, speech therapist that evaluate.
Well, I think we're very fortunate in this region.
Yes, we are.
For our life care period. It's a wonderful facility, both of these here, and you go just to Lynchburg,
and
somebody just like you is somewhere at all the
other
places.
Yes.
To me, it's nice to know that.
All care centers mm-hmm. are required to have a registered dietitian on staff or in consultation.
And obviously, nutrition has a lot to do with many things.
Yes, ma'am, it does. If a person is not well nourished, well hydrated, they're not going to participate well in the therapy that's going on. They're going to want to stay in bed, not get out, not socialize.
Depression will set in, probably.
Yes, ma'am. It's just a vicious cycle.
So
we work very hard with our families, also have regular care plan meetings. We value our family input.
Well, I think that's really important. nursing homes are not to be feared. They're to be revered, what the word is.
This is their home, Peggy, and we want to make mealtime a good time for them, a pleasant time for them. They
That's
look
good.
Forward to their three meals a day.
And they have, if they're able to get out of their room, then they get to socialize
sure.
during those times.
And we have several dining areas, and we also assess, do they need help with eating? Can they feed themselves?
Sort of, what is their schedule? Do they go to the dining room for the three meals?
That is their choice.
If they can, if they can.
That is their choice.
Yeah.
They're allowed, the dining room's open for all three meals, and then on each wing we have a day room that some residents prefer to eat there in the day room. But we just really want it to be their home.
And how long have you been doing this?
This will show my age, Peggy.
Well, that's all right.
Been doing this over 20 years.
Well, you're
associated
you're
with
obviously
Life
doing Hill. A good job, because I
well,
hear good things.
I appreciate
things.
That, and I do have a passion for working
for what you're
with
doing.
Older adults.
Yeah,
and all.
I think
do.
It takes a special person to see. I love old people because I am old. You know, I got to.
Well, I'm getting that way myself, Peggy.
So,
maybe they'll just make me a room, and I'll just move right,
right
in when I retire. But we have a fine facility here in Lynchburg.
So your
also.
Hours are like, what, 9 to 5
well,
or something
I am
like that?
There actually once a week on Tuesday
okay.
and then on Thursdays in Lynchburg. We have full-time certified dietary managers that I work with very, very closely that also assist in visiting the residents and assessing
yeah.
them and all.
And so how many residents would you, do you have room for other people?
Yes,
is there
ma'am.
Still room for other residents?
Yes, ma'am. I think our census today was actually 116 or something like that. But yes, we have room. You know, there's lots of coming and going. People
yeah.
being admitted, people being discharged.
And some people there for a short time,
some
for long-term.
Some for short-term rehab.
Yeah.
And those are ones that might need, Peggy, a more restrictive diet if they're younger, had a knee replacement, maybe going home afterwards.
Do you ever find that any of the patients kind of fight the what they're going to eat? Do they
that
rebel sometimes?
Yes, ma'am. And we work very closely to get rid of or take away the restrictive diet
yeah.
and make it more like they're used to eating.
So if they
home.
Really want some ice cream, they're going to get it?
They absolutely
remember that
get
when
the
I get there,
cream.
Okay?
Yes, ma'am. They'll get a little piece of apple pie to go with that ice cream.
There
if
you
they
go.
Want
that
to.
Sounds good to me.
We want them to be happy, and again, this is their home. And I
fresh fruits and vegetables,
yes,
probably.
Ma'am.
And actually, the whole world could take a note here.
Sure.
Nutrition is extremely important, and some people forget that. When they're stuffing potato chips down their throat.
That's exactly
yeah.
right. And we also, of course, have supplements available like Ensure, Boost,
yeah.
Those kind of things. We try to emphasize, though, food first, meaning we want them to eat
actually
their three
literally
meals.
Eat the three
they're
meals.
They're going to get more benefit by actually eating the meals than relying on supplements
yeah.
so much. There's a place for supplements. We certainly use them and have them. But if someone's not eating, if they've lost a lot of weight, like you mentioned your aunt, for example,
mm-hmm.
coming in from a home environment that she did not eat at home.
Right.
Because you know, she was by herself. And
even though the food was prepared and left there, she wasn't always eating
always
what she needed
eating.
To.
But
the cake would go first.
The cake
yeah.
would go first, of course.
That's
and
right.
even that still happens sometimes, and
well,
that's okay.
It happens in my house.
Yes.
We're all bad about that. We
all
need
like
to take
sweets.
Lessons in nutrition.
But we work very hard to make it a pleasant mealtime experience for them.
If you wanted to advise, say, somebody that is caretaking at home,
yes, ma'am.
What would be something you might say to the caretaker about their food?
I think one of the most important things as we age, actually, we have less calorie needs, Peggy,
mm-hmm.
because we're not as active.
Right.
And we have, say, less muscle mass. Our metabolic rate kind of goes down. I think the most important thing is to determine exactly what they will eat best and make sure it's not chips and junk food
yeah.
and soda. We don't want them filling up on that kind of food. They need plenty of fruits and vegetables.
Just like everybody.
Just like everyone.
They're just human beings that need
exactly.
to have a balanced diet.
Yes, ma'am.
But maybe not as much.
Yes, because they're not as active.
Yeah.
So make sure, again, you know, your bright colored leafy green
yeah.
vegetables.
Do you like
all the
what you do,
fruits.
Lois?
I do like what I do.
I can tell you do.
Well, thank you.
And I
thank
think that's a wonderful gift, because to love what you do, we'll make it work.
Been doing it a long time,
yeah.
and I do enjoy it.
So, yeah. Lois, it was delightful having you here. Any last words that you want to say would be fun?
Well, we would just welcome any any in the older people here in Tullahoma that would love to become and be a part of life care here in Tullahoma or Lynchburg or take a tour.
Do you have to actually live in Tullahoma to be there?
Absolutely.
Like if you live in Manchester, you can still come here Swanee.
Absolutely.
If you choose this facility.
So come and tour our facility.
I'll tell you what, it always is clean. It smells clean, and that means a lot to me.
We appreciate you saying that.
I think you all do a wonderful job.
And thank you very much.
Your staff is always friendly and smiling. So, Lois Termalin, nice to meet you.
Nice to meet you,
Peggy. I'm so glad you were here.
All right.
Let's go home and eat something nutritious.
All right.
We'll be back.
Oh, hello, ladies and gentlemen. This is the paint. I just knocked a tree over. This the paint doctor. I got the color wheel. Now, you know what a color wheel is? It is the wheel at the paint works where you pick all your colors to paint your room. It could be a multicolored beard. It could be a underarm fan. You never can tell. One thing we do know is that it's time to paint. You know, you can make your wife very happy if you go to your house and paint some rooms, or you paint the outside of the house, the inside of the house. It makes them feel very good because you work hard for them and they like that. All women like to see their man sweat, you know? They do. Honeydew is what they do. And you get to do it too. So you go to the Paint Works at 1960 North Washington Street and you see Dabbit Aikonen over there. And he's the real paint doctor. He fix you up with color. It's so nice when the color is right. Go to Paint Works today. Martin Senor. See, Martin Senor, right there. Martin Senor at the Paint Works. Bye, and we see you next time. I'm burning up.
You know what, guys? There's a lot of tree branches and dry brush over here. We should probably move the bonfire over there.
I'm guessing Smokey liked that idea.
All right, folks, and we're in South Jackson Goes Country mode here today. What I want to do right now is bring you, give you a little taste of some of the stuff that goes on. Here is Jacob Gray performing Strut.
This next song is one my dad wrote for me and some other people. We gotta keep your head high and strut through all the tough stuff in life. So get me going. Thank you.
Let the Smokehouse be your mountain getaway destination in beautiful Monteagle, Tennessee. Enjoy our cabins, restaurant, and old general store. Shop thesmokehouse.com featuring homemade barbecue sauces, jellies, and many other fine Tennessee products. Our live Music on the Mountain series features some of the best local and Nashville talent every Friday and Saturday night, 6:30 p.m. No cover, kids welcome.
If you want to be a parent, it doesn't matter how you play, what you wear, how you dance, or even what direction life takes you. You just need to be there. You don't have to be perfect to be a perfect parent. Thousands of teens in foster care don't need perfection. They just need you.
How long has it been since you raced a cheetah? Are your tornado creating skills getting rusty? Tired of being the only one in your neighborhood who hasn't built a dinosaur? Sounds like it's time to visit the Hands-On Science Center. The Hands-On Science Center is an indoor science playground. In this museum, please touch is the rule. Join us for weekly science demonstrations on space, lasers, lizards, rocks, and a whole lot more. No two visits are ever the same, so visit often to see our ever-changing exhibits and demonstrations. The Hands-On Science Center, 101 Mitchell Boulevard in Tullahoma.
Good morning, all you wonderful viewers in TV land, and thank you, camera gentlemen, for putting a good, sharp, clear, contrasted, colorful picture on the screen for our viewers. You know, this is a wonderful time of year, the holiday season, and it's amazing how warm it is at this time of year. The sun shines out, and everybody's on the move, and getting the holiday and Christmas spirit. And, you know, I was thinking the other day about a big promotion that Tullahoma had back in the 30s and 40s, and that was that everybody that trades in Tullahoma, all the wonderful stores that was there, got little tickets, like theater tickets, and they had a big drawing, and the drawing was held on the roof of the old Tullahoma City Hall that was between the old Traders National Bank and the railroad, right there at the corner of Lincoln and Atlantic Street. And these folks would come by hundreds with the tickets, and they would draw out of a big box or basket tickets, and when their number was called, they won a real fine bunch of prizes. And those prizes were consisting of groceries and clothes and toys and a lot of things that they could use. And they're very meaningful. And this always took place about a week before Christmas. Now, speaking of toys, you know, as we look back a lot of years ago, not only Tullahoma, but Tullahoma in particular, that the hardware stores used to carry buggies and baby buggies and scooters and bicycles and different types of toys like that. And then when the 10-cent stores came, well, they would carry a big, big variety of toys. And I'll never forget the wonderful toys, such as little cars. And now, of course, they have remote control cars and things of that nature. But the Tinker Toys and the Erector Sets and Lincoln Logs and those types, Monopoly and all those types of toys and play games were just absolutely wonderful. And we always enjoyed them. Now everything seems to be electronic for one reason or other, and they play games on the computers and things of that nature. But toys of old were just wonderful, and we appreciate them very much. And we are glad that we can remember those good things, and we are glad that you watched us today. And remember, this is not the end of the story, because there's a whole lot more to come. We thank you for watching, and we hope everybody has a real, real good day.
I forgot it.
Her nurse.
You need a claim number?
Her personal assistant.
Can we just grab a...
Her housekeeper. Her cook. Her accountant. When I started taking care of Mom, I didn't realize the challenge of playing so many roles. But above all, I'm still her daughter.
Visit aarp.org/caregiving to connect with experts and other caregivers. Together, we can better care for ourselves and the ones we love.
All right, ladies and gentlemen, we're back, and you know, right around the corner is football time in Tennessee, and all of our high school teams, of course, will be the first ones to hit the field before the colleges do, and then the pros. And what we have here today with us is my buddy and our great football coach for the last 22 or 23?
23, I believe.
23 years, Mr. John Olive, and it's always a pleasure to have John here with us. Coach, how's it looking?
Well, I can say this. We're a better football team this morning than we were a week ago this morning.
Very good.
You know, so from that standpoint, it is good, and they're making progress. Just not a whole lot we can do about not having speed. We've got one young man that runs decently, Kaysen Buckner, and then everybody else, it really falls back. And we've got young men that have worked to try to get faster. We've got young men have been going to speed camps and all kinds of camps. Sometimes you just, you know, like I told my two boys when their dream was to play for the University of Tennessee, and I had to look at them and say, your genetics is going to prevent that from happening. And so anyway, but we're working hard. It's been a good group to be around. And it's an exciting time of the year.
Yeah.
I've been watching these top 20 football games from last year. Last night, I think it was Mississippi State, Alabama, there
right,
on the SEC
right,
Network.
Right.
And I'm telling you, now that I know the winner of the game, so I'm not all caught up in who's trying to win, you just sit back and watch the artistic side of the game.
Oh,
and
it's
you
incredible.
See just incredible things being done. And I know our wide receiver coaches instituted a drill this morning because they were watching Amari Cooper last night from Alabama break people's ankles off as he made those stick steps.
Right, right. And, you know, the game not only, of course, I'm going to ask a question about, you said speed camp. You know, how far can you gain in one of those things? Can you make great strides?
Keep doing what they've told you to do, you know, whether it's the motion of your arms or whether it's your stride or the angles, because that's what everything is. It's built on angles and extension, making those muscles explode. So the stronger I get my muscles, for instance, when I was in high school, I was a 5-flat 40 guy. That's what I ran, 5-flat 40. By the time I'm a junior in college, I'm a 4-6 40 guy. Okay, well, number one, we worked year round at trying right. to increase speed,
right.
and I got a lot stronger. I became a man. And so my speed came down because I was working at it. And these young guys, they've been working, and I don't have any gripes with what they've been doing to try to improve themselves. We are what we are. We've got to play great team football. Chemistry's gonna be just super important for us.
Do you feel a good chemistry in this bunch?
We do. We feel like we gotta help it along though and mature, because it's gotta be, we've gotta become more close-knit than I will say the average team that we've had.
Right.
Because this football team, when we win football games, it'll be because we win in the fourth quarter.
Right.
It'll be because we stick together instead of falling apart.
Stay in
shape.
It's
not going to be because we just overwhelm everybody because we're more athletic than they are, and that's not going to be the case this year.
Well, and a lot of times, you know, you look at these teams, college teams, pro teams, all of them, that sometimes in the end is what makes it happen for them. And it's not always the blue chippers.
Sure.
You know, if you hit a blue chipper in the face enough times, a lot of them quit.
That's great. And your championship teams will have both qualities.
Right.
They'll be very athletic, but they'll have that team chemistry, that bond of love or whatever you want to call it. Band of brothers.
Right.
I mean, there's a common thing there that everybody is bought into, and they're not worried about me.
Right.
You know, that's willing to sacrifice. I'm willing to wash your feet if that's what it takes in order for you to be able to perform.
Right.
And that kind of attitude, that servant attitude, goes against the grain. Goes against the grain of what they've been brought up with, instant success and what's in it for me.
Right.
You know,
right.
How far can I go? What can you do to get me to go where I want to go to? And we're asking this team to buy into it more than probably any team we have in a long time. You're always trying to build team chemistry, but
right.
I just think it's essential for this football team.
Couple questions. excuse me. Your line, how's your size this year?
Size-wise, we're okay.
Are you?
We're not tremendously big, but we've got several big-bodied players. You know, across the board, we're probably an average. You know, I think offensive center, we're probably 190 pounds. Guards, we're probably 240 to 300. Offensive tackle, we'll have one, it'll be in the 250 range. The other one probably 240 range. Then when you start subbing, we're going to go to probably 170 pound guard.
Right.
All right.
Depth is a big thing.
Tackles on a drop, you know, weight wise and defensive line wise, you know, Jason Spry has been a great surprise, and he weighs maybe 185 pounds playing defensive tackle. But we've played with those smaller tackles before.
Matt Sweeten weighed what? 145?
170. Between 165 and 170 there that senior year when he was so good.
Yeah. Okay, next question. And I know the colleges and the pros, and they all get asked because it's all a quarterback driven deal up there. And they always say, all of them say, yeah, well, we're having a quarterback competition. You having a quarterback competition?
We
You've
are.
Got what? Three young men?
We got four young men trying to play, and we will, you know, keep that competition going. Some of it is because to get the athletes on the field that we have to play different combinations.
Right,
so
right.
That plays into the decision-making for us as well, because we're just not stacked with athletes. Our freshman football team is probably the best freshman football team we've had, though, since last year's seniors
right,
that graduated.
Right. Okay, we got a minute or so, a little bit left. What about this Wildcat football card?
All right, we've got what's called the coupon package. That our football kids have been out selling, freshman and varsity. It's got coupons inside it that you tear out. They pointed out that the first three would pay for the card.
Right.
You use the first three across the top right there in the, that are in the book, it'll pay for the card, and then everything else is free gratis.
Gotcha.
This card has other discounts on the back of it, so it's really two discount cards. We're selling them for $20. Our middle school will start selling them today. The smaller card has the schedule on it so that you can keep
first
up with the varsity.
First game is?
August 21,
here?
Coffee Pot is brewing in Manchester.
In Manchester. All right, that's Coach John Olive. It's Wildcat football time coming up, folks. Don't go out and get your tickets. They're on sale. The reserve seats start, I believe, the 8th.
I don't know. I've not.
You can start picking them up on the 8th through the 31st. So go Wildcats. We'll be right back.
We get closer to a world with more birthdays. When we take cancer patients by the hand, we help them find answers and guidance and hope, and give them more candles to light. We're the American Cancer Society. Help create a world with more birthdays at morebirthdays.com.
Serving you as a local firefighter.
Proudly served our country and the United States Air Force.
Serving Tullahoma.
Helping our kids.
Hi, I'm Terry Stroop. Your comfort is our service. We'd like to thank Tullahoma for the privilege of serving your heating and cooling needs.
Family suffers the loss of a loved one, the caring and compassionate staff at Tullahoma Funeral Home and Coffee County Funeral Chapel are standing by to assist you in every way possible. We are proud to support local industry and offer only Batesville caskets. Many funeral homes don't own or operate a crematory. We utilize the only crematory in Coffee County. Your loved one never leaves Coffee County. We can accommodate any need and any budget. Consider our complete pre-need service to remove this burden from your family during their time of grief. Lock in today's low costs and protect from inflation. Tullahoma Funeral Home and Coffee County Funeral Chapel. Our family caring for your family.
All right, we're back, and we just kept Coach Olive up here with us. We like having him here so much, and I want to remind you that we'll be showing all the Wildcat football games here on Charter Channel 6, and that'll be on Saturday mornings live at 9 o'clock, and then the replays Saturday evening and Sunday afternoon. So you keep that in mind, and they also, those games will all go on the Internet on our website. And be on Facebook, so you can watch them anytime, just about anytime you want to. And Peggy, one more shot on the country show.
One more shot on the country show, but go buy your tickets, 931-455-5321, or online, southjacksonciviccenter.org.
Doggone.org, that's
right. Get your tickets online, it's a lot easier.
We're gonna close the show today with Mike Sneed and singing and the opening, the cast with the opening act on the Friday Night Show 2013. Give you a little, another little taste of what's
that?
Going on.
Huh? Did you write that song?
Yeah, I wrote that song.
I thought so.
Okay. We'll see you, folks. Thank you for watching.